is so much fun. Here comes Andy Pandy in Andy Pandy Land.
After finishing his breakfast one day, Teddy went for a stroll on the green. He smelled something. It was a wonderful smell. The smell of food. Teddy had smelled freshly baked biscuits. They were still warm from the oven. Looby Lou had just brought Andy Pandy a tin of her extra special homemade biscuits. Andy asked Teddy if he'd like to taste one. Oh, yes, Teddy really wanted to taste one of Looby's biscuits. But his tummy was still full up with breakfast. Soon all the biscuits would be gone before Teddy even tasted one. Then he had an idea. Before he ate all the biscuits, Andy should really give Looby Lou a thank you present in return for them. Andy thought this was a good idea. He went to look for something really nice in his special cupboard. But the cupboard was bare. Still, they might find something outside that Looby would like. Bilbo the sailor had come to see what Andy and Teddy were looking for. When Andy said they wanted a present for Looby, he thought she might like a piece of his seaweed. But the seaweed looked rather old and dull. Andy thought Looby would like something more colourful. Andy and Teddy went to search on the green. Why was Tiffo the dog barking? They could only see blue sky. Tiffo told them he had just met a beautifully coloured bird, but when he tried to make friends, he'd accidentally growled and frightened the bird away. Andy and Teddy told Tiffo to cheer up and asked him to help them look for Looby's present. Teddy had seen something exciting. It was the brightest, most beautiful feather they'd ever seen. It must have been dropped by the bird Tiffo had just met. Andy thought the beautiful feather would be the perfect present for Looby Lou, and he couldn't wait to give it to her. But the feather was so light, Andy's breath blew it away. Never mind, Teddy would pick it up instead. Andy and Teddy were getting a bit cross. The feather had blown into Teddy's garden, but he and Andy couldn't reach it. Orby the ball had seen the feather floating across the green, and he wanted to take a closer look. Now the feather was blowing about in the breeze, so Andy and Teddy had to be quick or they'd lose the feather. Andy asked Missy Hissy to be careful with the feather, but she couldn't help saying how beautiful it was. Bilbo the sailor came to tell Andy and Teddy about the beautiful feather which had floated past his house. He thought the feather would be a perfect present for Looby Lou, but Andy and Teddy had already gone. The feather came to rest outside Tiffo's house. Tiffo was thrilled. He wanted to tell Andy and Teddy right away. Now Andy Pandy would never be able to give Looby Lou the beautiful feather as a thank you present. Andy had brought Looby Lou's extra special homemade biscuits as a picnic so he and Teddy could cheer themselves up. But they didn't feel like eating biscuits. And now Looby Lou was coming to see them. Looby was wearing the very feather Andy and Teddy had spent all morning trying to catch for her. The feather had floated into Looby's house through the window. She thought it was the most beautiful present ever. Now they all felt like eating Looby Lou's homemade biscuits.